I am Mary Lobo. I work at NASA, and this is my story. What I enjoy most about my job as Space Simulation Facility Manager is that I get to incorporate a lot of different skills. I have to understand the technical aspects of the job, be it mechanical or electrical, on how our facilities function. I do have to report and communicate the status of our facilities to our management so that everyone understands what's going on. And I have to use interpersonal skills in dealing with the facility team as well as the customers that are operating in the facilities. There are specific challenges that women face in today's workforce. When I was in a meeting here at NASA, I remember a comment came out that we have to talk to the graybeards of the facility. And that references to the older gentlemen. And I was probably the only female at the table. And I know my colleagues didn't say it meaning any harm, but there's a common acceptance that men are still the leaders and women take a back seat. So I know it's very important that women are present, sitting at the table, making sure our voices are heard and that we are accounted for. The most difficult moment in my career was being laid off in 2005. I took it as best I could, as anyone else would, but what I learned from it is that at no point in life can you be complacent. You have to always be ready to reinvent yourself so that you can keep moving on and progressing, growing, and changing. I grew up in a very loving home. Mom was the disciplinarian and Dad was the softy. But together, they were very supportive of anything my sister and I participated in. In fact, they came to every single event that we were involved in. They never missed one. And that meant a lot to me. The biggest influence in my life has been my mom. My mom was the one who encouraged me to get into the math and science fields. She has always been there and been very supportive in everything that I've done. Though I will say that all the decisions in my life that I've made have either been to please her or to spite her in my more rebellious days. But mom really told me that I needed to be proud of who I was. She never let me walk with my head down. She wanted me to be proud, independent, and strong. And she taught me that I had a lot to offer the world. I've been sewing all of my life. My mom taught me how to sew probably when I was 5 years old, and it's something we always used to do together. I continued sewing for many, many years until a friend of the family who was a designer recognized my talents and encouraged me to do a bit more. So one year, I entered a national competition called the International Designer of the Year competition, and I would come home every night and work on these two designs and sew into the midnight hours. And I actually won second place in this competition. And of course, my mother was right there by my side, smiling the whole time as I accepted my award. The most important lesson that I've learned in life is that closed mouths don't get fed. I heard that saying many years ago, and I believe it's true because there are no freebies in life. We don't always get opportunities laid at our feet. So you have to stand up, let your wants and desires be heard, and make sure that you are recognized. I would tell the next generation to learn as much as you can about as much as you can. You have to be well-rounded in life. It can give you a cushion to fall back on. It can open your mind to new ideas and concepts, and it can make you very fun to be around. I am Mary Lobo, and I work at NASA.